entire antenna is very similar to a patch. So I'm generating the radiation pattern using a patch simulation. Now I'm changing the value from 5x5 to 1x1 elements to simulate a single patch antenna. Now this is the patch antenna radiation pattern. This is a 10 dB patch, as you can see. Now let us change the value to 1x2 to simulate the double patch antenna, or two patches combined. As you can see here, this is the radiation pattern of two patches combined together, and it's a 12 dB antenna. The beam width now for the horizontal axis has increased, but the vertical axis is reduced. Okay, this is the transmitter source, the 2 mini watt video transmitter. And now we are 200 meters away from the video transmitter. I have the single crosshair on my video monitor. Now let's take a look at the video range test result. Okay, I'm getting colors. Now if I turn the antenna to the left, losing colors. Okay, this is about 45 degrees to the left. Back to the center. Now I turn to the right. This is about 30 degrees to the right. 45 degrees. Okay, I'm losing colors. Okay. Not too bad for the single crosshair at 200 meters away. Okay, now I have the twin crosshair antenna, which is the pepper box. Now let's take a look at the range test. I'm getting visual and colors. Now I'm turning the antenna to the left. Colors at 45 degrees. Still getting colors at 45 degrees on the right. Back to the center. Okay, the vertical beam of this antenna is a bit narrow, as we can see here. But the horizontal beam is good. Getting colors on both sides. With the single crosshair. This is with the single crosshair and a truck blocking the line of sight. Using the twin crosshair array, the pepper box. Getting some static and colored video. Okay, now let's try the single crosshair.